Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. In this video, we use the criss-cross method to factor the following five problems. All right, we're going to try factoring 8x squared minus 14x plus 3 using the crisscross method, which is explained in another video. So we take the factors of 8 and the factors of 3, and of course it's a plus 3, so we know we have the same sign. And since the middle term is a negative 14 here, we know we're going to have two negative signs here. All right, so what are some possibilities for 8? Well, we could use 8 and 1, or we could use 4 and 2. So how about I just write 4 and 2? And then we want to write factors of 3, but we want to make sure that we don't put a common factor next to one of the numbers on the left here. So for 3 and 1, 3 can go either place and 1 could go any place. So let's just go ahead and put 3 here and 1 there and see what happens. So remember, since it's a negative 14, it's really going to be a negative 3 times a negative 1. These factors have to multiply out to be positive 3. These two factors have to multiply out to be 8. Okay, so we're going to crisscross. So 4 times negative 1 is negative 4, and 2 times negative 3 is minus 6, and that's a negative 10, and that is not the same as 14 or negative 14. Remember, if it's the opposite, sometimes you could adjust the signs and it'll work. But this is the wrong combination. So let's do it again. Try something else. Let's keep the 4 and 2, but switch where the 1 and 3 go. So we'll put the 1 and 3 here. Again, they're both going to have to be negative. And we do the crisscross again. We've got negative 12. And multiplying those out, you get negative 2, and that gives me the negative 14. That's the correct middle term here. So, to factor it, this was the right combination right here. Right? So, remember what that really means. In one parentheses, it's going to be the 4x minus 1, the other one, 2x minus 3. So, that's what we want to write. 4x minus 1 times 2x minus 3, and then of course make sure you check your answer by doing the FOIL method or any other method for multiplying these two binomials, and make sure you really do get 8x squared minus 14x plus 3. Alright, here's another example. Try it on your own first by putting the video on pause if you'd like. Alright, so here we go. We're going to take the factors of 4 and the factors of negative 9. Alright, so the factors of 4, well, you could use 4 and 1 or 2 and 2. I'll go ahead and just start off with 2 and 2. And then the factors of negative 9 mean, well, we're going to have to use opposite signs. So we can either put 9 and 1 or 3 and 3. Okay, so let's start off with 3 and 3 to see what happens. 3 and 3. 1 would have to be negative. Okay, and go ahead and crisscross. So 2 times 3 is 6, and then 2 times negative 3 is minus 6, and that's 0, but I need to get a plus 9. So that didn't work. So 3 and 3 didn't work. Let's go ahead and keep the 4 with the 2 and 2 again, and how about trying 9 and 1, see what happens. Okay, so we're going to crisscross, and oh, have to remember one of these is negative. It doesn't matter where you put the negative, just try it in one place, and if it doesn't work out, you could always go back and change it. So let's put the negative one here. So crisscross, 2 times negative 1 is negative 2, and then 2 times 9 is plus 18. And that gives you 16. That didn't work either. Now, if I would have gotten negative 9, then instead of positive 9, we could have just switched these signs, but we didn't get that either. So let's try something else. It looks to me like 2 and 2 is not going to work. So let's do 4 and 1. And we'll try 3 and 3 again. Remember, it's negative 9 here. 3 and 3, and we're going to put a minus in front of one of them. Let's just put the minus sign here. And crisscross. We've got 12. And 1 times negative 3 is minus 3. And that gave me positive 9. It even gave me the right sign, positive 9. So there is the winning combination. These are going to be your factors. So now we could fill it in. So we're going to have 4x minus 3 times x plus 3. And then, of course, you're going to check your answer by multiplying that out using the FOIL method or any method for multiplying two binomials. Here's another one. Feel free to put the video on pause and try this one on your own first. Okay, here we go again. So we're going to have the 4, and we've got the negative 15. So we'll try factors of 4. We'll try factors of negative 15. So I'm going to go ahead and start off with 2 and 2 again. And factors of 15, well, we can do 5 and 3. Both of those are okay here. But to get a negative 15, one of them has to be negative. So let's go ahead and just put the minus sign here and see what happens. So we've got 6. And then 2 times negative 5 is minus 10. And, I got the answer the first time. So we've got the winning combination already, because remember we want negative 4 for the middle term. So that was nice and easy. So we have 2x minus 5 and 2x plus 3. And of course, you do want to multiply that out completely using the FOIL method or any method and make sure you really do get 4x squared minus 4x minus 15. All right, here's our next example. Ooh, you're looking at this. Wow, you see a 24 and a 15. You might be tempted to just go ahead and start. But there's a problem here. This is harder to factor if there's a common factor you could take out first. So, before trying this method, first look at the entire polynomial here and pull out the greatest common factor. So what's the biggest thing that goes into 24, 66, and 15? That's going to be a 3. And there's also a factor of x everywhere. So first factor out your 3x, which will give you 8x squared minus 22x plus 5. And now you have a much easier problem to factor, this 8x squared plus minus 22x plus 5. Now, your final answer is going to still have that 3x there. So I'm just going to write down how it's going to end up looking if it factors. And then I'm going to take this 8x squared minus 22x plus 5. And let's figure out the right combination using the crisscross method. So we've got 8 and we've got a plus 5 here, right? So this is going to be easy for 5. There's only two possibilities, 5 and 1. So you may as well just put a 5 and 1. And now we just got to pick a number for 8. So we can either use a 4 and 2 or an 8 and a 1. I'm going to use a 4 and a 2. But over here for this plus 5, I got to be careful. The middle term is negative 22, so I want each of these to be the same sign. They're going to have to both be negative so that I'll get a negative number for my middle term. So let's try crisscrossing. That's a negative 4 minus 10. That did not work. That got me a negative 14. So that was the wrong combination. So let's try and switch where over here we'll put the 2 on top of the 4, see if that makes any difference. So we'll keep the 5 as negative 5 and negative 1. And how about we switch this to 2 and 4? Because that will make a difference with a crisscross. So what do I have now? Got negative 2. And 4 times negative 5 is negative 20. And that gave me the correct middle term right here. So that's the winning combination right here. That's the one that worked. So we go back up here. Now we're going to plug in. What does this represent? This is the what would go in the first parentheses. But don't forget the x. It'll be a 2x minus 5 and a 4x minus 1. And as always, you should make sure that when you multiply 2x minus 5 times 4x minus 1, you really do get 8x squared minus 22x plus 5. And then make sure when you multiply all of that by 3x, in other words, do the distributive property on the 3x throughout these three terms, that you get the 24x cubed minus 66x squared plus 15x. Make sure you check as you go along that if you multiplied it back out, you would get back to what you started with. But we're looking for the factored form, so this would be our answer. If we would have not factored out that 3x, this would have been a hard problem to do. So make sure you always take out the greatest common factor before you try factoring that trinomial. All right, here's another problem where you hopefully notice that you can take out a greatest common factor. So try this one on your own. All right, what's the greatest common factor? 2x squared. So we could pull out the 2x squared, which leaves us with 2x squared minus 38x plus 24. And now I have a nice quadratic trinomial to factor. So my final answer, if it does factor, remember, is going to be broken up into these two parentheses. Don't forget, you have to keep writing this 2x squared. So now let's go down here and factor 2x squared minus 19x plus 24. So we've got the 2, and we've got the positive 24. But remember, we're going to have the same sign, so they're both going to be negatives. Just to make it easy, I'm going to write the minus sign there. All right, what are the only possibilities for 2 for as factors? Well, it can only be a 2 and a 1, nothing else even possible. And so we could choose what we want here for 24. Now remember, you could do 1 and 24, 2 and 12, 3 and 8, 4 and 6, there are a lot of possibilities. But let's say you tried to do 12 and 2. Well, if you put a 12 and 2, that just is not going to work out because you can't have a common factor here, right? As long as you took out the common factor to begin with, there's not going to be a common factor here. So you're not even going to try to put the 12 or the 2 next to that 2. So 12 and 2 isn't going to work. The same problem with 4 and 6. 4 times 6 is 24. You can't have a 4 or a 6 next to this 2. So right away, that gets you down to, well, what are you going to try? 1 and 24 or 3 and 8? Well, can we put an 8 next to the 2? No. So we like eliminate a lot of possibilities right off the bat. Let's see what happened here. See if we got lucky. So we've got 2 times negative 8 is negative 16. 1 times negative 3 is minus 3. Got negative 19. Yahoo! That's what we wanted. And so this is the winning combination. So that represents the 2x minus 3, and that's going to be an x minus 8. We just go back up here, put that in the parentheses. 2x minus 3. And x minus 8. So the nice thing about this crisscross method is you eliminate a lot of possibilities right away, like 4 and 6, neither of those could go here next to the 2, and the 12 and 2 couldn't go here. So I was, you know, I couldn't put an 8 on top, so I really just had to do 3 and 8, or it could have been maybe a 1 and a 24. There really would have only been two choices to even try for your trial factors. Okay, so those are some more examples with the last two. Being careful that you always, always, always see if you could take out a greatest common factor before you just start factoring. And, of course, this is one of many methods of factoring. It doesn't matter how you get that final answer, but you have to use some method that makes most sense and is easiest for you to work with. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.